You only need two things to make a homemade air conditioner. I'm sure you haven't heard of this method for home cooling yet. It's significantly cheaper and produces amazing results. You can create it in less than 15 minutes. Prepare two bottles. Cut off their bottoms at about the same height as I did. Then, make holes in the bottles. You can use a soldering iron or even toothpicks. Leave about 4 centimeters from the cap without holes. This will be important later. Now take a fan and remove its cover to make it easier to work with. Get 4 zip ties and attach the bottles. You'll need 2 zip ties per bottle. Attach them to the fan's wires and the holes in the bottles. If you have any excess plastic, cut it off. We can now close the fan. Our final step is to put ice into the bottles. When you turn on the fan, the ice will help the fan produce an air conditioning effect. If the ice starts to melt, just place a glass under the cap and drain the water. You can add more ice cubes at any time. The effect of this homemade air conditioner is fantastic. You'll feel the difference immediately. Buy it at the pharmacy and stick it on your windows. It's very cheap, and your apartment will quickly become cool. If you don't have external blinds or air conditioning, you know how hot it gets in the summer. It turns out that this foil solves that problem. An ordinary emergency blanket has 2 sides, 1 gold and 1 silver. Each has a different use. The silver side reflects heat, while the gold side stores it. Measure your window glass precisely. Then cut the blanket to the appropriate dimensions. Wet the window with regular water and stick the blanket onto it. Use a cloth to smooth out air bubbles under the foil. Stick the silver side of the blanket on the outside. The gold side should face inside the room. This way, it will reflect the sun's rays. You'll notice the difference in just a few minutes. Apply it to windows on the south side. These are the windows that let in the most heat. I've been using this trick in my home for years. It makes heat waves much more bearable. 1 drop is enough. The glass shelves in your refrigerator will stay clean, won't fog up, and you won't see any stains or streaks on them for up to a year. This trick is genius. It allows you to postpone cleaning the fridge. You just need to occasionally wipe away crumbs. Nothing will stick to the shelf anymore. Steam won't appear on it even if you leave the fridge open while looking for something. This is probably the best and most amazing trick you will ever try. The next time you clean your fridge, use it. Empty the fridge and remove the glass shelves. First, clean them thoroughly, each one. Then dry them well. The glass must be dry. Next, take a soft cloth and literally 1 or 2 drops of glycerin. You can buy glycerin at most drugstores. It's very efficient, so a small amount will last a long time. Use this small amount of glycerin to polish the refrigerator shelves. Do this on both sides. It might seem impossible at first, but polish until the glycerin disappears and the shelf is dry again. From now on, you'll see that the shelves will never fog up. If something spills, it won't stick to the glass shelf. You just need to wipe the shelves without removing and washing them. Glycerin leaves a protective layer, and this is the best way to keep your refrigerator clean. Put plastic wrap in the freezer and see what happens. It will gain new properties you didn't know about. Everyone has plastic wrap at home. We sometimes use it to wrap delicate pastries, but more often we use it to pack regular sandwiches for school or work. Then we always try to have it on hand. It's very useful. However, it has its drawbacks. It's hard to unroll. Especially when the roll is new, it's difficult to start unrolling it. You can easily solve this problem. Just moisten the plastic wrap or your hands with water. If you run a wet hand over the plastic wrap roll, you'll easily find its beginning and unroll it. But once you manage to unroll it, it's hard to tear it off. It tears unevenly and gets all stretched out, sometimes endlessly, and unfortunately, it often sticks together. But there's a trick. One trick will make the plastic wrap very easy to tear off and won't stick together. There's one condition. You have to put it in the freezer. The low temperature will make the plastic wrap easier to unroll and tear off. It will be a bit stiffer. It won't stretch out as much, and it won't stick. If you use it very often and don't want to open the freezer all the time, keep the plastic wrap in the fridge. This will make using it much more pleasant. You'll forget about all those problems it can cause. I wrap the pipe from the kitchen sink with aluminum foil. The effects were visible after just a few days. This trick was shown to me by a plumber. I'm sure you've never heard of this use of tinfoil before. A lot of dirt and grease builds up in the pipes of the kitchen sink. When washing up, food residues get into the pipes. They are responsible for the bad smell from the sink. To wash up, we use warm water, which dissolves the grease. In the drain pipes, it begins to cool down, blocking the flow. It turns out that all you need is ordinary aluminum foil. Tear off a large piece. Then tightly wrap the foil around the pipe with it. Cover the entire surface of the drain pipe with it. It has thermal insulation properties. This will keep the water flowing through it warm longer. Oil and oily sludge will drain into the vertical pipe. It will not settle in the trap pipe before draining. I have tested this trick myself, and there is no longer a bad smell coming out of my sink. Even after pouring leftovers from the pan, I am delighted that such a cheap and simple way really works. Don't store food in ice cream containers. You'll be shocked at what happens to them. You've probably thought you had ice cream in the fridge, only to find dill inside. Many people don't throw away ice cream tubs. Instead, they use them in their kitchens. This is a huge mistake. Ice cream container manufacturers didn't anticipate such uses for the containers. Putting leftovers, meat, salads, or soups in them can be dangerous. My mother-in-law used to do this, but when I told her about it, she immediately stopped. What's the issue? It turns out that some food products interact with the containers. Reusing packaging can allow harmful chemicals to leach into the food. The warm temperature of the dish can precipitate chemical components from it. Ice cream containers are not suitable for storing dairy and eggs. Plastic promotes the growth of dangerous microorganisms. Processed meat loses its taste and nutritional properties. Cheeses may begin to smell musty. Food in such containers molds much faster. Moreover, we should store food in transparent containers. Ice cream containers are colored with chemical paints. The quality and application of this plastic are not intended for refreezing. Put a sponge in the fridge. You'll be surprised by what will happen. You'll definitely want to brag to your friends about this trick. This trick is very simple and cheap, and it will help you with a problem that often occurs in fridges. But first, ask yourself, when was the last time you checked the products you keep in it? Some of them simply need to be thrown away. They can make the fridge smell bad. Take a look inside your fridge. Do you also have water droplets on the shelves or on the back wall of the fridge? If products stick to such a moist back wall, ice can form on them. And standing water on the shelves, if you don't notice it, starts to smell bad. There are two ways to prevent this. You can handle it with a regular dishwashing sponge, but don't worry. It's not about cleaning the fridge with it at all. Take one sponge and cut it under the rough surface. Make a small hole with a knife or scissors. Pour salt inside. Now place such a sponge on the shelf in the fridge. The sponge will absorb moisture from the shelves. Salt also absorbs moisture. So it's a simple and cheap fridge dehumidifier. The second method is to use another product. Sprinkle baking soda on the sponge and place it in the fridge, preferably in the bottom drawer. The sponge will absorb moisture and the soda will additionally absorb unpleasant odors. If your fridge smells strange even after cleaning and washing it, try these simple and cheap tricks. You'll be surprised by the result, like my mother-in-law.